Do you want to add a remote control to this inverter for less than $20? I'm going to teach you step by step how you can do this. As you can see, it works. This video, I'm going to tell you a little bit before we start with the practice, so that way you know how to connect it if you never have done this before. So this is the inverter. You are going to have the logic board or motherboard inside of the product. Also, you're going to have like a big transformer. So what you're going to have in this case in the front of the inverter is just the switch. I'm going to show you. So once you have the switch, you have to tap into the switch. You have to grab the little electronic board that I'm going to show you. Also, all the links, I'm going to leave it in the video description if you want to buy it. And for less than $15, you can have your own. So the advantage of this is because I have an AIMS inverter, and it's very good. I like it because it's a charger, also it's inverter, two things at the same time. And the only bad thing is that the remote control, it costs like $160. So I think it's too much for a remote control. So in this case, at least my experience with the all other brands is that you have the remote control and then you have to go to the unit, you have to turn it off, and then you use the remote control only to turn it on and off. It doesn't make much sense to me. I prefer to be able to turn it on maybe when I am in the other room where I have the inverter, for instance, in this truck. And when I go to this room, I want to be able to turn it on and off as well. I don't want to just think, okay, is it on, is it off, here is not working or whatever. So I don't know, maybe with the AIMS I don't have any problem, but I decide not buying it because, like I said, it's $160, and I said it have to be a better way. So I was thinking, okay, I'm going to use one of these wireless switches that work on 12 volts, and this is what I did. So I bought this 12 volt switch and I put it here. This is the input of the inverter. So I tap the, obviously inside you have the positive and the negative. I tap both, and then what I did, I bridge it here so that way I have power 24/7 in this little switch, wireless switch. So easy, and it doesn't draw that much power. It's very little. It's almost you're not going to notice. And here you have the positive and the negative. So, and you have another two terminals that is for the relay. So for the relay, you have to tap into that and connect it into the switch that you have already. And the only downside is if you leave it on here, you're not going to be able to turn it off from here. But if you leave it just off from here, you're going to be able to turn it on and off from any of the remote controls. So in this case, what I did, in order, because you're going to think, okay, then I'm going to have the same problem like if I buy the same the original remote control, you know, from the factory. Okay, you understand, but listen to me. So in this case, because this switch, they come with two remote controls, what I have is one in this room, one remote control in this room, and the other one next to the inverter. So instead of touching the inverter, I leave the inverter alone, and the only thing that I do is I use the other remote control, the one I have in the other room, the other one that I have in this room. So with both, I can do it just fine. And let's say what happened if you have a school bus or something like that, and you have many rooms, you want to have it, you know, you want to have more than one remote control, you can buy more remote controls, and you program it with the switch, and that's it. So you can have as many as you want, and it works just great. So I'm very happy with this option that I came up with, and it's very economical. It costs less than $20. If you want me to do it for you, just send me the inverter, I can do it for you, or just follow step by step what I'm showing you right now in this tutorial, and it will be a success for you. So now I'm going to show you step by step, and let's start with the video. Here we have the switch. In this case, we have the AIMS power, but if you have any other brand, it should be the same. So we have a regular switch. If you turn it on, it will be inverted by itself.
like that is off, but in this side it will be power save mode. So usually the save mode is kind of limited, but I'm going to activate it just in regular mode. That is the mode that I use the most. So with a few dollars, I'll teach you how to do it.
All right, what you need to buy is this device. Is a switch, a wireless switch. It comes with these two remote control. You push it, and then it will turn on, will turn, switch off, basically. The only thing I don't like about this is that you have to pry it a lot on the side to remove this cover. And as you can see, it has a small hole here only for these two cables. Those two cables I just added, it doesn't come with any cables. And this side, this is the part that you're going to use. You need this three. So as you can see, we have to make a bigger hole. So I'm going to use the Dremel to do that. And this cable that you see here on your right is for the positive and negative. And this two that you see over there is only to turn it on and off. So this is like doing this. It's like working like this. So it will turn it on and off. So we can still leave this switch. So in case if you want to use it like that, but I'm going to connect these two on this side. So that way you can turn it on and off wirelessly, and it costs very little. This I paid like $15. So if you can compare it with their remote system, it costs like $160. Makes no sense to spend so much when you can do it just the way I'm teaching you right now. All right, I'm going to show you how to use the multimeter. So it's off. You put it on ohms, on diode. You push this so that way when I touch this, makes the noise, so you know when the switch is working. So now I'm going to show you the switch, so that way when you hear this noise, you know that the switch is working. Right now, I have it in ohms, as you can see over there. And then what you have to do is you grab the alligators and you put it in the yellow one and in the red one. In this case, this is what I need, because this switch is a three position. So if I push this, you see now it's working. As you can see, it says that the noise means that we have the right side. If we put it in the other side, it will not do anything. I don't care about the power save mode. All I care is the other mode. So we are going to install the electronics here, and that should do the trick. So that is how you can tell which side you have to use. If you want me to do it for you, send me your inverter and I can do it for you. Otherwise, just follow my step-by-step tutorial and you should be good. Right, in this case, we have this, the terminal assortment. This kit is very cool. So you have all the sizes, but I'm going to show you here. In this case, we have this. I have done this already. So basically, when you put this inside of this type of connectors that you see here, the problem is if you have a weak cable like this, even if you put something, it will not be strong enough to go all the way. So what you do, basically, you grab one of these, depending on the type of cable that you use, you put it all the way until you see the other end. Hopefully you can see it. And once you do that, what you're going to grab is this tool. So basically you put the tip inside of that and you squeeze it, and that's it. So you put it like that, squeeze, done. So now you can pull and it's strong. So now, because it doesn't matter in this case, it's just a switch. You can use any of those here. And that's it. So now we are going to untight the screws so that way it will go all the way or as much as you can. And that's it. So I'm going to put one at a time. There we go. So as you can see, now we adjust it. Hand tight is enough. As you can see, we're going to do the same thing. There we go.
Now you do the same thing here. And that's it. So what I did here, I put a super glue. So this is firm against the metal. So it should be good. Now we should be able to try to put it kind of far away, because here in this case, we have the other connector. So I think it should be good, because we should have plenty of space. Worst case scenario, we can put it just here, but this is what I have right now. So let's see how it goes. We can build the other cable. So we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to put this cable here and here, and we're going to connect it to the battery that we have here on this side. We have to do the same thing in the other end. We're going to grab the black one. I did this with this, as you can see here. We're going to put it just here, and then we're going to go, you see that is too much, but we can go just here, put it just inside, press it, that's it. That should be strong enough. So the positive is on this side, as you can see here. I'm going to untie this. Ahí está. All right. All right. It went through. Now I'm going to adjust it. There we go. You pull. It's firm and tight.
All right. As you can see, I removed the screw, so that way I had access to the other. In this case, this is the inside of the inverter. As you can see, I unplug everything. It's very easy. You have just a few, one outlet, one plug here, another one there. That's it. It depends of the model that you have, but this is what I have. So I used the Dremel to sand it down a little bit. I was able to solder here. So this is the positive. As you can see, we're going to put this so that way if we have to unplug it, the case, we don't have to solder here or cut or do anything like that. So always like this, as you can see here. If you have this, is so that way if you remove the cover for any reason, easy. In this case, I'm going to do the same thing with this. So in the other side, I was able to remove the screw here, as you can see. That goes here, and I tried to solder it over there, but I couldn't, so I unscrew this screw that you see here, and I'm going to put this over there, and that should do the trick. Use the female, so that way it will not touch anything. And here we have one, and the other one is over there, so hopefully you can see it from there. So now we can put the cover back and everything should work. All right, as you can see, here I added this piece of cable, so that way I can plug it in here, as you can see. And as you can see, we have the light here, so it's working. Now I should push the button and everything should work. So I can put the cover back, and I will be ready to plug this in, and this cable too, and everything should be good. Okay, as you can see, I just put the cover back, and we should be ready to go. All right, it works perfectly. Usually this type of remote controls, you have to connect it here. I want to turn on the lights so that way you can see. And even the cheapest one, you're going to pay like $40. And the one that comes with the display is like $160. So this is wireless, less than $20, and it does the job. As you can see, you push the button and it starts working right away. And if you turn it off and you want to turn it on with the switch, normally you can do that as well.
We'll be right back.